This is never happened before. Well, hello people, my name is Avery Miller and welcome to Game Glitch. I do apologize for doing less Game Glitch videos recently. I'm always trying new stuff, so that's something you should expect from my channel. New stuff, you know, I do these like vloggy type things and then I do Game Glitch stuff. Anyways, that aside, the Night in the Woods video I made a while back has over 30,000 views at the time of recording this, and I think it's actually since hit almost 50. So that's insanely awesome. Some really cool people have even seen the video and reached out to me and stuff like that, which is unimaginably cool. Happening here with this audio thing. My audio equipment is malfunctioning. Please hold. Oh! That was terrifying. This is what happens when you buy analog speakers. But since I'm here for the money, I am going to give you what you want, so prepare your body. More Night in the Woods stuff. This will hopefully be the last video I do on Night in the Woods, for now at least. I don't want to overcover something, but enough time has passed since the game came out that a lot of glitches and hacky stuff has been discovered that I didn't cover in either my other two videos. I thought another one could be in order. So, that being said, keep in mind that the dev team actually actively fixes glitches. So by the time you watch this, it might not work, or I mean, it might work like the game is supposed to, but the glitches won't. I think you get what I'm saying. Although we're gonna start with a bit of a fun thing that even you can try at home, and it's probably not gonna get fixed anytime soon. You'll see why. It's the speech bubble editor. It's an editor that allows you to change what characters say in the game. It doesn't have much of a practical use other than to allow you to make some pretty goofy memes. I thought I'd just show you how to set it up because it's really cool. So obviously whoever made this is a genius, but just head over to the GitHub repo or the GitHub page as you normies would call it and download the latest release, unzip it and run the .exe file. After the window has been opened, you can go into more, click on the run setup button and then click the enable file watcher button and you're all ready to go. This is great. Go over to files and you have all the text said inside the entire game. The first one I found was the file from the beginning of the game with the poem that is super depressing. So I naturally thought I'd add a bit of a plug in there. I ran the game, but not before resetting my save file. May, Greg, I will always love you. And surprisingly enough, it worked. There it is. And the problem here is that there aren't actually any characters on screen saying the dialogue, so I can't show off how to program emotions or anything like that. So I did the same thing, only with the first janitor scene in the game. Any second now. Subscribe to Avery. Dude, it worked. OMG. It actually worked. Now this is, wow. That's a first for me as well. Night in the Woods uses emojis to program expressions into the dialogue. Like here, I had put in a slash O forward slash and it made May hold up her arms. And since I didn't program a put down arm thing into the dialogue, May holds her arms up forever or until it gets overwritten later on with different dialogue. When looking at the other text used in the game, it cracks me up because it might as well be like a roleplay transcript with the smiley faces and the arms being held up and stuff. I don't know, it's cute. You guys should really try it out, make a backup of the dialogue first, and then you could literally rewrite the entire game from here. There's also a similar script by Ember Imp? I don't know. He made both of these, so, you know, thumbs up to him. But anyways, on GitHub, it lets you edit your save file. Third time's a charm. This might be the most glitchy, hacked Night in the Woods video I've made as of yet. As shown in this README file here, you can actually change the amount of drawings you have in your journal thing, which is, hey, me showing off something that is actually a little bit useful for once. Although that being said, I couldn't really figure out how to run the code, honestly. I think if you open the .sln file in Microsoft Visual Studio, you can get it to launch. But I'm too rushed to get this video out. Now that I'm thinking about it, actually, I might have downloaded the source code and not the release. So that's, oh my god, I'm a moron. Just forget I said anything about the me not being able to figure out how to write. I digress, ignore me. On the first Night in the Woods video, a gaming to make games commented on the video saying that they had found a very strange glitch in the game themselves. Now he, I'm assuming, I shouldn't I apologize. I don't know your preferred pronoun there, but they were able to capture footage of it, and it was kind enough to let me show it here. Like I said earlier, this stuff gets fixed a lot of the time, but I don't think you're really going to be trying to replicate this glitch anyways. I don't even know why you're watching, but I love you for it. How I understand this glitch is basically it lets you go out of bounds, and it's done by going from the snack falcon, or rather that general area, to downtown, and all you have to do is move in the opposite direction right after the loading screen ends, I think. And you just drop right out of the game, and it appears that it somehow bypasses the trigger that would restart the loading screen. So I don't know, crazy stuff. GTMG, as I affectionately will call them from now on, notes that if you keep moving around in this off-screen world, you eventually just respawn at Greg's and Angus's apartment, or at that statue at the center of the town, and it seems to sort of be random. And like I said, big thanks to gaming to make games. Well, God, like I've said before, this game is something else. Can't even describe it. I have trouble listening to the music because it just brings tears to my eyes. I've gone over that in a lot of detail, but I just want to emphasize this game. And that's really it. I think glitch and hack wise, we've covered everything. So hopefully I'm not going to be making any more videos on Night in the Woods, because I feel like I'm squeezing everything I can out of this game, and I sort of feel bad about it. Now, I've gotten art, and I hesitate to call it fan art, because especially today, the art has been made by my friends, mostly. But what the heck? Fan art. So I'm going to do this anytime I get fan art. I'd never ask somebody for free drawing, so the least I can do is feature art I get in videos. If you do happen to make fan art stuff, I mean, send it over. I'd be happy to put it in a video. First comes from GlitchMutt. Be sure to check out their YouTube channel. Super amazing art, as always. I mean, Mutt here has like 2,000 some followers on Furry Amino. I don't even have to say anything. I think that sort of proves itself. And also a really awesome sketch, I guess you would call it, from Tonic, who is also a friend of mine, completely insane. What I'd give to be able to draw those eyes like that. I feel like some sort of furry icon. It's going to my head. OMG. Okay, I have OMG written out in the script. Just do I say oh my god, or do I say oh? Okay, that sounds a little bit cringy, but I don't care. Now, as always, I depend on your guys' support to keep making videos, and watching and subscribing is always enough, but if you have a dollar you want to throw my way, for whatever reason, feel free to head over to my Patreon. There are some pretty great rewards for those who give a little bit more. And by little bit more, I mean any money at all. Love you guys, and as always, stay fluffy. Oh my god, it hurts me every time I say that. I feel so, I want to say cringy, but you have to embrace the memes. Stay fluffy, lol, :3. Okay, wait, before I go, can I talk about something? Okay, because at least 2 or 3 times in the comments, people have complained about me having a lisp. Okay, I mean, maybe when I was 5 or something. I don't think it's really super pronounced, right? Like, with all the stuff you could make fun of me for, okay? There's lists and lists. I know people who keep lists of stuff that they can make fun of me for, because that's what they love to do. There's hundreds of stuff before that you could make fun of me for besides, but instead you completely disregard those stuff and you just make fun of me for having a nearly non-existent lisp. That's what you choose? I don't know. Okay. Lol, lol, lol. Okay, love you, bye.